Jameis Winston. Jameis Winston signs with the New Orleans Saints. He had other offers on the board. I wasn't sure what to think of this initially. But coming out after, you know, a day or so of thinking about it, I think this is a genius move by him and his agent. It obviously wasn't all about the money right now. He wanted to be in a good position to learn under a really good quarterbacks coach to get better at his position. I think this was a smart move, not only by the Saints, because obviously you know that there's talent there, but also by Winston and his agent. Do you disagree with either one of those?
I don't disagree with this is his only path to being able to stay in the league. Okay, but I think he realized, I don't think this was a decision he made, okay?
Okay.
I think this is a decision made for him. Now, I know that his agent floated out there that they had more money offered by other teams, but we don't have any names on those other teams, and the NFL kind of leaks like a sieve.
True.
So I think this was his only route to success, which was taking the backup role. And, yeah, I would rather go play for an offensive-minded coach that might be able to help me. My biggest problem with that is Dirk Koetter is a pretty decent offensive-minded coach and has ran a pretty good offense for a long time. And Bruce Arians is second to nobody in the NFL. And those guys couldn't fix him.
Yeah, that's okay.
It's not like he worked under Bill Belichick or, you know, one of these Ron Rivera, a defensive-minded guy that doesn't give a crap about the offense usually and just hires other people to handle those things. He's only had offensive-minded coaches, and all of the quarterbacks that have ever worked under those guys have been pretty good. So
yeah, they typically do it. You've got a very valid point there.
That's my only
point. Typically
it's not improve. Like Sean Payton can fix them.
Yeah, I don't know that. I think this will be the first time that he has actually had to sit behind somebody and get a chance to learn a locker room, learn all that kind of stuff. I mean, as soon as he got to Florida State, he was the guy. As soon as he got to Tampa Bay, he was the guy.
And that might be the most important thing is he's going to a place where you're not the leader.
Yeah.
See, one of the things that we criticized, the quarterback that went to from Oregon that went to the Chargers,
Justin Herbert.
Jesus Christ, I've been looking at these names all weekend and I've forgotten it. Herbert, yeah. One of the things we criticized Herbert for was not being a great leader. There's a lot more NFL locker rooms where the quarterback's not a leader than you think. I think leadership in the NFL is hard to fake.
Yeah,
and I think the biggest mistake Tampa did was bring him in as a rookie and say, you're now the leader of this locker room. He had no business being the leader of that locker room.
Yeah.
And you're right. That might be the most valuable thing for him is you're not a leader. You're going to sit down, you're going to shut up, you're going to learn. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right. I like this position because, like you said, he's not the leader here. He gets to learn under a better quarterback. I don't know that he's ever been in a place that had a better quarterback than him. I think that would help out. So, but we'll see.
Last year he was at a place with a better quarterback than him. And the year before that, he is at a place with a better quarterback than him. They just didn't trust that guy to give him the ball.
Okay. So he had Fitzpatrick 2 years ago.
Not last year. I don't know who the backup was last year.
Yeah. Nobody knows. Because it would have been
the 2 years under Fitzpatrick was a great opportunity, but that's Tampa Bay leadership and general manager forcing this kid on the organization and saying he's got to start right now. This guy's going to be a star and not letting him grow.
Yeah.
But he did have a better quarterback in the room that's better than him.
Yeah. That's okay. Golly, that's so much thinking, right?
It's just an organizational thing. One organization tried to force him on the team before he was ready, and the other organization is going to say, no, go sit here and hold a clipboard.
Yeah,
and we hope that you never start a down this year, ever.
Or the next year, because Drew Brees has a two-year deal. So
Drew Brees' two-year deal is gone because he's got a bigger deal with NBC starting next year.
Is it bigger? Is it actually...
Oh, yeah. I think he's going to make more money with NBC than he will with.
I mean, you might be right.
I might be wrong on that. I don't know that the details are out, but I think big TV guys are getting, man, maybe not his first deal.
But he's going to be making some cash. So we know that much. So
anyway, I think he's a one-year deal. I think he is gone. There's no NBC wouldn't have signed him if he was going to be 2 to 3 years away from coming to them.
Yeah, I could see that. 1 year, and that's, again, smart play, I think, by Winston. Okay, there's nowhere that you are going to be the starter this season, like unless you're waiting for somebody to get hurt or somebody to really mess up, right? Kind of like Mariota in Tennessee last year when Tannehill was there. Like, you're going and you're hoping. But with this, Michael jumps in on Twitch. He said, "Happy Monday, fellas. Hope you had a good weekend." It was a fantastic weekend. We had sports this weekend. It was good. I think this is a smart play because you have a year to learn under somebody better than you with no real responsibility other than the fact that, you know, Breeze missed like 5 games last year and it got Teddy Bridgewater's starting job this year. Like, something like that could happen again. Possibly.
I mean, that was Breeze's first time Breeze has missed a game in a long time, and it was a fluke thumb injury.
Agreed, but he
has not been an injury-prone guy. Now
he's still older. The other side of 40. So
correct. No, he is older.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know. I think the best thing for the organization is bringing him in. They'll get to see him for an entire year of practice, and then he never touches the field. That's the best thing that could happen to that organization. And then here's the red flag. If Drew walks away next year and the Saints say, "We're good, we'll pass," I think he's done in the league. I don't think any 31 other teams can touch him because they just saw him for an entire season. The problem with going to a place like New Orleans is if next year they pass on you, I think that's the nail in your coffin.
Yeah.
But if he were to have gone somewhere else to where maybe possibly he could have competed for a job really cheaply, then he can at least stay in limbo for a couple of years.
That's a valid point. All right, the other topic, the big move over the weekend, Trent Williams,